a tall wagon form factor, Subaru symmetrical all-wheel drive system, and the legendary 2-liter Boxer 4 with a hybrid twist. Could this be the most crunchy granola Subaru of all time? Let's hop behind the wheel of this 2014 Subaru XV Crosstrek Hybrid and check the tech. Now, the interior should come as no surprise if you've ever seen or sat in a current generation Impreza, because like I said, it's basically the same vehicle. Inside, we've got an interior that's nice. It's not going to convince you that this is a luxury vehicle, but that's not really the point here. What we do have is materials and a design that reminds me a lot of what Volkswagen's doing right now. It's simple, it's understated, it's not going to wow you, but it's also not going to feel really cheap when you touch it. And that's a good thing at this price point. In the center of the dashboard, we've got the standard infotainment system, and it's not really going to wow you, but it does have a lot of good inputs. We've got an auxiliary input, we've got USB and iPod connectivity, we've got Bluetooth for hands-free calling and audio streaming. Now, at the top of the dashboard, we've got our multi-information display, and that's going to be a small screen up there that's going to basically show you a variety of information about what's going on with your fuel economy and the hybrid system. So we've got not one, but three different fuel economy screens. One's going to be historic, two are going to be instantaneous. We've also got the all-wheel drive screen that's going to be on a lot of these current generation Subaru vehicles, and that's going to show you what your all-wheel drive system's doing. But because Subaru all-wheel drive systems are symmetrical, all-wheel drive full time, it's pretty much just going to show you that it's in all-wheel drive all time. It's a pretty useless screen in this situation. And then finally, we've got an interesting screen. It's the fuel saving screen. And what that's going to do is show you how much time your engine has not been running. Now, one of the benefits of a hybrid is that you're able to shut that engine down and run in electric mode every now and then also shut it down when you're idling. So this is going to show you how long the engine's not been running when you're behind the wheel and how much fuel you've saved. Now, under the hood, it doesn't look very different from what you would expect to find underneath the hood of pretty much any other Impreza platform vehicle. Right here in the middle, we've got our Boxer 4. It's going to displace about 2 liters, and it's going to punch out of either side, so it's wide but not very tall. That's going to be mated with Subaru's symmetrical all-wheel drive system that's going to put power to all four corners. Now up front, we've got also two batteries. That's a little confusing. Usually you only see one underhood battery and one in the trunk battery, but we've got three in total here. I'm not really sure what Subaru's doing here. And even though Subaru is frequently a partner with Toyota, this hybrid system has actually been developed completely in-house by Subaru. Toyota had no hand in it. That probably explains why it's a little weird. In between this engine and the all-wheel drive system is an electric motor that's been paired with a continuously variable transmission. And that's actually going to give this car a fuel economy bump thanks to a nickel metal battery pack that you'll find in the trunk. Fuel economy here is 33 on the highway, 29 in the city, and that's going to average out to about 31 miles per gallon. That average is only about 3 miles per gallon more than the standard XV. Part of that is because this vehicle is about 300 pounds heavier. Here we're looking at about 160 horsepower and 163 pound-feet of torque. That's about 12 more horsepower than the standard XV and about 18 more pound-feet. And if you wanted to have a little bit more fun with that extra power, you could actually shift virtual gears with the paddle shifters. You got sort of six faux gears there, but I wouldn't really bother because fun's not really the point here. I've been able to cruise in pure electric mode at speeds about under 20 miles per hour. If you're in stop and go traffic and you're creeping along at under 20 miles per hour, you'll be able to take advantage of that EV mode to save fuel. But you won't be able to do it for very long. There's not a very big battery on this thing. But at highway speeds, this CVT just sort of holds your RPMs at a weird sort of drony level. And so you kind of get this weird constant humming. And it's even worse when you're trying to do a 0-60 run. The revs just kind of jump up to about 5,000 or 6,000 RPMs and they just hang there. You don't really get that sort of satisfying shifting. And of course you can shift yourself, but they're fake shifts, so why even bother? And the transition from gasoline to electric power can be a little bit less than smooth. And even though this car has about 10 more horsepower than the standard XV, it just doesn't really feel like there's a performance gain. It doesn't really feel like there's a big efficiency gain. And so it seems a bit like you're just paying an extra $4,000 for a car that's quieter when you're idling and has a hybrid badge on the outside. Now, pricing your 2014 Subaru XV Crosstrek Hybrid is easy because there are only two choices to make. There's the standard model that starts at $25,995, and then there's a limited model that's going to add navigation, leather, and a power sunroof for about $30,000. Either way, it's a dubious sell because the advantages that you gain over the standard XV are minimal at best. And if you're looking at a hybrid, you've got the C-Max and the Prius V that are going to give you a lot better fuel economy here. The weird thing about this XV Crosstrek Hybrid is that it kind of overcomplicates Subaru's simple message. So for my money, I think I'd go standard XV or I'd get a real hybrid.